Of course, it's 7:27 a.m. Blue Mountain. Yeah, this is beautiful weather up here, guys. It gets cold up here. I just want to show you the weather, what it looks like today. Looks like it's going to be blue sky today. It'll clear up. We're going to see some beautiful sky today. Now, you guys come up. See, little kids like touching things. Yeah, little kids like touching things. So this is life. Like I said, this is where I'm at, staying at. You do need to buy one of these, folks. I guess in May, June. They say in July they'll start getting water back up here on this mountain, but I don't understand this. The internet says May and June, don't come up the Blue Mountain, raining all the time. You get washed out, world's washed out. I come up here and it's all dry on this thing. Yeah, it happens every year this time of year. But this hostel probably has water. But there's nobody there at parties there. Only here. Right there. So, but right now I'm eating farmers. They're picking the cocoa berries. Or the coffee berries. And they say they're going to take back off in 2 weeks. So, I don't know how this place is going to be after June. But in December, they say there's a lot of people up here from around the world traveling. Which you'll probably have water up here. I doubt it. I doubt it, though. Could I live up here? If I had water 24 hours a day, a store right next door to me, yeah, I could live up here 24 hours a day. And a bar with full of nice, beautiful women to talk to. Yeah, I think I could live up here, but other than that, there's no stores, about 20 minutes walking distance from here. Now they have another little, I'm gonna make another video, I'm gonna walk to the store. I'll show you guys the town up close. I gotta get some drinking water. Today, maybe tomorrow. Depends how much water I have. But they have a line that's coming way up off the mountain up there. And this line goes probably 5-10 miles maybe down the canyons. Goes to this one little town. And everybody is picking up their, getting the water for their houses down there. So I thought, cool. She's going to get in trouble. Look at her. I'm going to see what she is up to. We'll catch her on camera what she does. She's interesting, man. She wants to touch everything. You turn your back against you, man. You go and find your shit scattered everywhere. Do you like these homes up here, guys? Some nice homes over there. And it goes down the canyon and it drops down. There. Well, that little girl, she's kind of quiet. Shocking the heck out of me. Well, I just wanted to show you the weather. How it looks like 7:29 a.m. in the morning. It feels good, guys. Now, in Kingston, when you showed up in June, when you do show up in June, trust me, it's going to be hot down there. You're going to step outside and you're going to go, hell no, hell no. I don't want to feel this on my body all day long, every day. Well, I hope you've seen my other videos. Yeah, I got to go. We're in trouble now. We're in trouble. This kid's going to do things I don't want her to do. Okay. Press some buttons. Her brother grabbed my little light and radio, and he turned it on, clicked some buttons. I'm telling everybody, how can you shut this off now? They're going, hell, I don't know. I said, I don't know either, man. He turned it on. The light's on. You can't get the light to shut off. I just said, okay, man. You see that light? It's red. It's been on ever since. Everybody's going, man, it's going to drain your battery out. You can't shut it off. The kid's going to press some buttons and delete my whole computer. Come back, I don't have no hard drive. What the hell did you do to my goddamn laptop? Okay. All right. There you go. Let's see if that'll keep you off the keyboards. You touch buttons, and what you're going to do is going to delete my computer. And I'm not going to have no hard drive. I'm going to lose all my videos. And you're just going to laugh like you're doing right now. Now, for the marijuana smokers and non-marijuana smokers, I invite you both to come up here. This lady's been cooking me food for now, what, 3 days I've been up here? And they fed me fish last night. But this is what it is. He bought a whole bunch of food for his family. A whole bunch of chicken. I said, how much did this food cost? And he tells me it was like $9 of our money. Less than $9. And I said, okay, here's the money. 100 pesos, 100 more, $100 more, which is like a dollar. Because it's $116 to 1. $116 to one of our dollars. USA dollars. So I went up to him the next night and I says, how much did I need to feed your family for until Monday? And then I said, I can get some money hopefully Monday. And, because I'm broke. Now, I got a little bit of money to get my ass back downtown, but yeah, it's not feeling good. So come up with lots of money when you do come up here. Because don't be expecting what you read on the internet. So I ended up giving him like $30 more for 3 days to feed me and his family. And they came up with fish last night. A whole bunch of fish. They fed their family. I thought it was only a family of two. It's like a family of five up here. So be warned, everybody. When you volunteer to pay for everybody's food, you're paying for everybody's food. For $10, I can't go down in any restaurant and get a meal for $10. So it's like, okay, here you go. Let's go. I paid $10 a night down Mexico to eat very good in a restaurant, so I'm used to it. Well, good luck in having a good dinner in the United States for $10. Hell, you probably get a pizza and a beer for $10 if you get lucky. But they served me this fish. I didn't know what I was eating, man. I was spitting out these bones and said, "What the fuck am I eating, man?" Guy goes, "Fish." I said, "Man, hell, I was so lost. I thought it was chicken. We've been eating chicken for the last 2 days." But then they threw up that pond duck is the name of it. They killed a pond duck bird. And I ate some of their soup. It was dumpling soup. That shit was good. And they gave me a little piece of the meat, a little piece of the bird. Yeah, it was the back spinal cord. No meat on it whatsoever. So, thank God I didn't want to taste that poor bird. But it tasted good inside the soup, though. Oh. There's no way you can get a hold of these people on the internet. I went to all the hostel internet sites trying to find hostels in Jamaica. This guy didn't show up. What you do is you find him on hostel. I'm not going to stay here too much longer, so I don't think I'm going to make his website. Unless we go downtown and he pays me for free food for the rest of the week. Feeds me the rest of the week. I'll probably set his website up or take photos. But like I said, I went to Mavis Bank. You can get a bus to Mavis Bank, okay? And I guess that's the cheapest way. Probably gonna cost you about you know, I think this guy was talking about $4 or $5, but I think it's going to cost you more. It cost me $81 to take there's a place when you walk out of the airport, Jamaica Airport, right as you walk out the door, it's Putan. I already spelling that in the last video, so go see my other last video. But they charged me $81 to come up here. I'm getting bored. I'm getting bored on you guys because you've seen my other videos and you say, "Man, I've already heard this fucking goddamn crap." I'm turning this shit off. Well, I'm going to be walking all the way across there, up the mountain, over the mountain, and then back down the mountain. And then about halfway down the mountain, there's a little town that sells food, has water. Oh yeah, hey everybody. Since you've seen all my videos, I was able to go to their school from here to there, 20 minutes. Their daughter goes to that school. So she knows how to get internet access. And I was able to take her, my laptop. They gave me the code, but the code that they gave me to get on Wi-Fi, it didn't work, and luckily she had her little iPad, and I was able to get on the internet and pay a bill that I forgot to pay in the United States, and wrote to my children telling them I made it to Jamaica. So, I think that might be valuable information for you guys. I don't know how long that last. It was nice of the school having Wi-Fi, leaving it open on Saturday and Sunday. Oops, they'll probably shut it off now. I hope not. There's a guest house, too, on the other side of this mountain, the first town before you come up here. There is a guest house up there, and they do have Wi-Fi, and I was not able to connect on my laptop. Don't know why, but if you guys want to live in luxury, there's another hostel. Now, for sure, they have water in the other hostel, because it said something guest house. is what the name of the place on the Wi-Fi. And I don't know the name of it. I forgot it. Palenque is a guest house or something like that. Now, you guys bring up a tent and a hammock, and if these guys are full, you do have places to lay out your tent around here and set up tent, enjoy life if you really have to, guys. Oh, I set up my hammock up here, guys. Yeah, that was the worst mistake I ever did. Set up my hammock up here, man. I'll tell you what, if I would have let that little girl's boy play on it for 5 minutes, I wouldn't have had a hammock anymore. So everybody told me to take it down or you'll lose your hammock. So I took it down. Oh, and I was able to sleep in it last night to keep the mosquitoes away from me because I bought one of those hammocks with the screens. Yeah, I threw it on my bed and used the head post up there and tied the strings up, ran it all the way down. I slept good last night. Not that much room in it, but it didn't touch your face, it didn't touch your arms. So I did sleep good. And I'll be sleeping it the rest of the week because I have my door open up all night, letting fresh air come in the place. And as for robbery and thieves, I can walk away, leave this stuff right here, and come back, and the stuff be still sitting there. My door to my room. Oh, he did give me a room to the place for $2,000 Jamaican dollars for 20,000, should I say, for 23 days. And he gave me a room with a bathroom and a shower. Believe it or not, my first video I made of this place when I showed up here, he was just offering me a hammock place for $1,000. And he ended up just giving me the room after I shut down the video. He goes, "I'll just give you this room, man." So, but I'm not going to stay here for the 23 days I was wanting to stay here. It'd be cheaper for me. If you see my last video, just see my last video, okay? I'm gonna go to Strawberry Fields. What money I'm gonna save, I get free rent. They says I can set my tent out on their property anywhere, look over the ocean if I want to. He goes, he has a nice place where he could set it up at. I got lucky. I met this guy with a lot of land around St. Mary's. He was naming all the fruits and vegetables he has on his property, all the trees, all the types of different mangoes. And I'm going, "Dan, the more you talk, the more I'm going to go follow you, man. You're going to be looking at me. Every time you turn your back, you're going to go, 'Get the fuck away from me, you white man. Just don't follow me anymore. Get the hell away from me. Don't follow me home.'" Now, everybody's broke up here. So remember this, guys. You will have my people offering you to take you up in the mountains. And they'll take you up in the mountains, and when they come back, they go, "Hey, this is how much I want from you." Or you tell them you want this much for a bag of weed, and they come back and you go, "Whoa, I got a shitload of weed." And later on they come back to you and they says, "Well, this is how much you owe us after you smoke it." And you're going to say, "What, man? You want this much for this crap? Here, just take this seed weed back." Yeah, seed weed is what I call it. Seed weed. Yeah, he wanted $800 Jamaican dollars for a pound up here, but it was very, very seedy. And I told the guy, I says, "Too much work for what you want in life." He got really offended by me, man. I said, "I don't want you to be mad at me, man. I just want quality marijuana, so next time you go buy or grow quality marijuana, make sure you do it the right way. He left and I didn't see him again. But I wouldn't even dare to try to make even hashish out of that motherfucking shit. The seed weed. Now, I do not like smoking in front of children. But, they're at a young age where they're not going to pick it up yet. But if they were like 9 or 10 years old, I'd be turning my back away from them. But everybody here, they just smoke weed in front of the children. It's like it's natural, it's normal. I don't like kids picking up their parents' habits, because I picked up my parents' habits. Yeah, I picked up a lot of my parents' habits. What you see throughout your life is what you do throughout your life. Yeah, remember that, everybody. Remember that, everybody. Like I said in my last video, I'm going to try to hike, because see this leg? Let's see if you can see the scarf. I have a plate holding this leg up, plate holding this leg up here. I got screws going in. If you can see how wide this knee is compared to this knee, this... See that? See how it's not big and this one's fucking way out of shape? Well, it all shattered right here. All those bones shattered. All of it. All the way up this leg. So they put me back to screws and shit. So I got 7 screws here holding this leg up. This part of this leg from here down. And I'm going to show you this on my other video before I take off up the Blue Mountain. And there, I got a plate holding them going into my hip, my femur bone, and I got 5 screws holding this leg up. And I couldn't even walk 2 nights ago, man. I couldn't even walk on the leg, man. I was hurting so bad. I was going, fuck. People go, man, where's your cane at? It's in the bedroom. But I woke up in the morning, felt good, but I think I can make it up to Jamaica Mountain, Blue Mountain Peak. Yeah, see my next video. I'll talk more about what I've done in my lifetime while I'm up there. Blow you away what I've done on my birthdays. But this one just came out. I wasn't knowing what I was going to do on my birthday. And this guy just come up out of the blue and says, hey, let's go up to Blue Mountain Peak. And I said, fuck you, man. Let's do it on my birthday instead. I says, I'll buy the food. We just take some beers up there. And we're just going to have a good time. So from here to Blue Mountains, 4.5 hours, okay? 4.5 hour walk from here to this place. There's one more hostel, like I said, it's right over there, but nobody hangs out there like they hang out here, okay? Now, if you get one of these hostels, come up here and mingle around with the growers, okay? They don't mind. Just come up here. That's good advice if you really want to go do some serious damage. You know, my those little kids even stuck their finger on my lens on my camera. They touch everything these little kids do, man. Don't let your shit out there so they can touch it. But this guy right here says he'll drive me all the way up to the peak until he can't drive any further. And they say it will take 2.5 hours of walking distance off of us. Now I'm going to talk to this owner and see how much he's going to charge me to drive up that mountain to where we have like 2.5 miles to walk. That far I can hop, skip, and jump that far with a backpack on my fucking broken legs. Yeah, it's going to be a thrill. Well, you guys see all my other videos. see what I do in life. To gross you guys out, make you turn my videos off. But that's me in life, man. I don't give a fuck what you guys think about me in life. I honestly don't give a fuck what you guys think about me. But you better give a fuck about what you think about yourselves in life. That, I trust me, you need to hear my words very clearly in life. Well, I'll show you the bag of weed I got to smoke today. Supposedly I have a pound coming up here. Somebody's delivering me a pound of weed today or tomorrow. Should I say tonight or tomorrow? This is the shit that you buy up in Blue Mountain if you don't buy the crap down Kingston first. Now, Kingston, they wanted 10,800 dollars for a pound, which is about probably about $170 a pound. You come up here. This looks like Mexican weed. I swear up and down, this is the shit I smoke in Mexico every fucking day. This looks like government weed to me. This does look like government marijuana in Mexico. This is the shit that you buy. What a cheap fucking camera. But I paid 50 cents a gram for this, is what you pay up here. And you don't go buy a bag of weed, alright? when you give up here in Blue Mountain where I'm staying at, you give them $10, they come back with 20 little bags of little fucking half grams or grams of weed, and you're going, what the fuck? Yeah, about 20. Yeah, it's a gram a bag. And you start turning the bags up and putting in one container, man. You should see where the bathroom's at. I don't want to show you this, but man, I think this is fucking funny as hell, man. This kid's just pissing right over the side of the wall. Oh, fuck, man. This is so funny. All right. Yeah, that's what I got on the internet last night. Well, I gotta go, man. See you folks later. I gotta watch this. I gotta babysit this kid around my shit. This guy is destructive. And be warned, that comes with this when you rent a place up here. But I advise you guys to come up here. The people cook your food up here. You're gonna have to have a shower bag. You're gonna be flushing your toilet. They do have a toilet. But you'll be flushing it with water that they bring from another town. There you go. That's how they're delivering their water up here, guys. Just like that. Every home up here is doing that, okay? Except, I don't see them doing that. So they have water there. But they're on another water system. They're not hooked up to the city like these guys are. But, that's interesting, you guys, isn't that? His sister was up here dancing yesterday with his grandmother, with her grandmother. I wanted to videotape it so much, but it only lasted for a few seconds. By the time I got my camera out, it was over with. Yeah, that little girl that you seen on video earlier, she just dancing away. Hey, what are you doing? No, don't touch it, all right? You know why you guys touch things? And then you turn around, you delete things, okay? All right.
Put the flashlight.
Don't you remember? Hey, don't you remember what you did my flashlight, the radio yesterday? How you broke it yesterday, because you was touching it. You remember? Huh? You remember how you broke my radio yesterday? Uh huh. And you want to break my computer? So much for the dancing. I tell you, man, and the United States government wants to kill these type of children through vaccines, through GMO food, from chemtrails. Oh, man. There are some Jamaicans that are waking up, like United States is waking up, and they're not vaccinating their children up here. I don't blame them. Matter of fact, the mother of that kid, I seen her in some shorts the other day. She has this big old hole in her ass. And I said, what the hell happened a year back? She goes, a vaccine. I said, I hope you're not vaccinating your children. She goes, hell no, I'm not. Loving life. Yeah, everybody. Don't vaccine your children, nor you. Best advice to do in life. Matter of fact, I'm sick to my stomach. I don't even want to talk about it no more. Y'all has a good life. Enjoys your life the fullest, like the hippie Derek. The hippie terrace does in life. Yeah, I should have a nice hot shower in about 3 hours. That's if the kids don't touch it. Boy, they are touching it, man.
Ah!
Well, I don't know what you kids do to break my things, but man, enjoy it. Is it warm?
Mm-hmm.
Is it? Okay.
But me, I want to them back again, and I'm going to know what I'm doing.
Did you understand a word he just said to you?
Give me
and be warned, the Jamaicans up here, they speak a language you will not understand. One word. And I've heard many languages in my lifetime, man. You hear their language? You have to come from their ancestry to know what the hell they're saying in life. Bye. Enjoy my next video. You'll like the walk I'm going to do today. Or maybe tomorrow. That'll be my next video. Maybe. Maybe. Maybe not.